Throat's not good. Blame it on the rains.
If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now.
What's up guys, I am Rob. Welcome to my channel. So a lot of you have been sending me your requests and your suggestions, and like I mentioned in my previous video, all my new upcoming videos will be based on your requests. And even in today's video, I am fulfilling one of your requests. Today we are making a very simple calligraphy pen. Now before I get into it, I just want to say I am not great at calligraphy. I did some when I was in art school and on various projects. I tried working with different fonts, tried different brushes and calligraphy pens. So yeah, I did it then, and after that I haven't touched it. So today's video will also be like a refresh for me, testing out my calligraphy skills. Thanks for suggesting. Let's get into it. Get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So today we are making a very simple calligraphy pen. For that, I am using ice cream sticks. So these are just plain old ice cream sticks. I'm gonna take one. And all you need to do is, you need to cut the ice cream stick in an angle. So for that, if you want, you can draw a line, a diagonal line like this. And then take a cutter, then just cut it along this line. When you're using a cutter, be extra careful. Don't hurt yourself. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to just go over the line. And what I'm doing is, I am just applying a little bit of pressure and creating a groove or a dent, just like that. After you cut it a couple of times, you can just apply a little bit of pressure and just snap the little portion off. So you can see that it breaks very easily because we already created a groove here. But now, as you can see, the shape is slightly uneven, and for that I am going to use sandpaper. Just keep the sandpaper on the table or on the floor and take your ice cream stick and just rub it like this. So what you're doing is, you're sanding it and making it smooth. You don't have to do a whole lot. Once you do it a couple of times, you will notice that the tip becomes nice and smooth. Right now it's pretty flat. What we'll do is, we'll also rub it like this so that the edges also become slightly more smooth. Do it on both sides. I am basically making the tip of my calligraphy pen slightly more angular, because that works better when you're making shapes which are more angular, or when you're drawing strokes which are curvy. So make sure you sand it well and get a nice smooth angle. And there you go, your calligraphy pen is done. So this one is a plain and simple flat tip. What you can also do is, you can make smaller cuts. There is a little more variation in your strokes. And what I'll do is, I'll take another one which I've already cut here and make two small grooves in this. And for that, I'm going to use my cutter and just take out two triangular pieces. So simply like that, I have cut two small triangular pieces. So you can see now this has become slightly more jagged. So when I make a stroke with this, instead of getting a nice flat thick line, I will get three different lines. So there will be a little bit of a design or a pattern or variation in my stroke. So this is the plain one and this is the angular one. Okay, so the pens are ready. Now let's put them to the test. So I have a notebook here. It's better to do calligraphy on sheets that have lines, like guidelines that you can follow. Like I said, I'm not great at calligraphy. So this is also brushing up my skills. So let's see what I can make. Okay, so I'm taking some ink here. So this is your regular fountain pen ink. Let's pour a little bit in the cap. And now I'm bringing in tissue paper. Tissue paper is to just dab the extra ink from your calligraphy pen. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I am just dipping the calligraphy pen, which is our ice cream stick, in the ink. And then I'm just dabbing the extra ink. And then we'll just make some strokes on paper. So you can see right now the strokes are slightly faint, not very bold and dark. And also the edges are pretty crooked because the ice cream stick is still absorbing the ink, because this is wood, so it absorbs some ink, and only after that you get a nice bold strokes. But right now my strokes are slightly more faint, but because the strokes are slightly lighter, there is a nice gradient effect happening here, which looks pretty cool. But as you can see, my lines are pretty shaky. So you have to practice a lot when you're doing calligraphy. There are a couple of things that you have to keep in mind, that the angle of the stick always remains in one position, so you can't keep changing the angle. You have to always hold it like this. Another thing is, it's all about the wrist. So you have to practice. Only then your strokes will be nice and clean. Right now you can see, because I draw so much and I'm pretty fidgety when I'm holding a pencil or brush, my lines are all shaky and not so neat. But hey, we're using an ice cream stick, so I'm still pretty happy. All right, so you can see the kind of strokes I'm getting. You need to keep practicing all the alphabets on these guidelines, so you are pretty in tuned with the strokes you want or the angles you want. And once you are happy with it, then you can try it on any surface you like. Okay, so we have practiced a little bit with the flat tip calligraphy pen. Now let's try the other one, which has a slight variation. Look at that, it looks pretty cool. Instead of one fat stroke, I'm getting these three lines, which look really nice. So you can experiment with the kind of strokes you want. Instead of making these three tips, you can make two, or you can make one fat one and two small one, so that there is a slight variation in your stroke and you can create your own fonts. Also, what you can do is you can make your calligraphy pen slightly thinner, because right now, as you can see, I'm getting a really, really fat stroke. So you can just cut the tip and make it thinner, or you can just slice the ice cream stick in half so that you get two calligraphy pens out of one ice cream stick. All right, so I am done practicing with these fat tip calligraphy pens. And now I'm taking this thinner one that I've made so that my strokes are slightly thinner or narrower. And after all this practice, let's see if I am ready to write something that looks good. Like I said, I'm not actually very good at calligraphy, but this is my attempt to make something look nice. Let's go for it. So I'm gonna write something that I truly believe, and I always say. Let's see if you can guess what it is. And there you go, we are done. I know it's not perfect, but I am pretty happy with the result. And like I said, if you practice more, then obviously your strokes or the fonts that you're using, whatever you're writing, will be nicer. So practice more and enjoy your calligraphy pen. There you go, guys, that's how you can make a very simple calligraphy pen. I know it's not the best, but it's great to start with, and it's very simple to make, so you can get a hang of how to do calligraphy, and then you can move to a more advanced calligraphy pen. In fact, that's what I'm gonna do. I think next week I'm gonna make a more advanced and more efficient calligraphy pen. So if you guys enjoyed watching this one, tune in next week so you can try making the more advanced one. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then please give this video a big thumbs up, like it, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, subscribe to my new vlog channel, Robin the Hood. That one. And also, I'm on Instagram, two handles, so you can follow me there and send me your pictures or comments. We can have a chat. We can have a chat here too. So in the comments below, let me know what you are going to write or make with your new calligraphy pen. That's the end of this video. I'll see you in the next one with another simple and fun DIY. And like I always say in the end, do good and be good. Peace.